What's good, y'all? Welcome back. In this video, we're going to look at the MATLAB desktop environment and explore some of the features that we're going to use most heavily throughout the quarter. First step to this process is to get MATLAB open. On my Mac, I'm going to open a new tab to do so. So I'm going to hit Command N. That opens a file window. Let's go down to Applications and then click on the version of MATLAB we want to run. In this case, I'm running R2020B. We'll talk more about that in a different video. That immediately brings a copy of the MATLAB desktop up on my computer. We're going to talk more about the different features of this desktop. For now, let's go to the Home tabs. These three different tabs, this is called the Home tab, the Plot tab, and the Apps tab. Notice that when I click on the Home tab, it's highlighted in a different color than the other two. Over in this small menu area, let's go to Layout and click on Default. That will bring us to what they call the default layout for our MATLAB desktop environment. We can think about this as the MATLAB desktop. The default layer has a few different features that we're really going to use heavily in this class. The first one, which is highlighted right now, is called the Command window. You can tell that this is an active sub window of the MATLAB desktop because the title command window is in white and then the actual kind of title bar there is highlighted in that nice beautiful blue. I could also highlight what they call the current folder window, which is over on the left here in the default layout. We could tell that's highlighted because now that's in blue. To activate any of these, all I have to do is really click on it. So for example, if I wanted to activate what they call the workspace window, just click on it, turns blue, and we see that it's activated. These three windows, the current folder window, the command window, and the workspace window, constitute what they call the default layout for my MATLAB desktop. You can tell the title of the window by looking up in this tab at the top of each window itself. This thing is called the command window because it literally reads command window. This thing is called the current folder window because you can see current folder. This thing over here is called the workspace window because it's literally reading workspace. One of the fun features of the windows that we have in the default layout is that we can either dock them, D-O-C-K, dock them, or undock them. If we think about the desktop environment, MATLAB's desktop window here as a mothership, we can think about each of these windows as small escape pods where we can do specialized work. For example, right now I have the command window activated. We see that because it's highlighted in blue at the top. Over here, there's a little right arrow, downward arrow on the edge of that command window. At the bottom, you see that it says undock. The moment that I do that, I now have the entire command window in its own tab on my desktop, and it gives me a lot more real estate to play with. However, let's say that I wanted to dock it back in the desktop. I can go to that little drop-down menu, go back down to dock, and then it will show up right where it started to begin with. I do want to mention something at the edge of each of these commands. Do you notice that the undock has this little upward caret, upward pointing arrow, and then U? You might not be familiar with what those symbols mean. And one of the things I want to teach my students is how to learn this material without me. A very great resource at this point is to use any online search browser. I prefer DuckDuckGo for almost all of my searches. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and say MATLAB shortcut keys and go ahead and see if I can find, there it is, the support@apple.com, and I go ahead and click on that. Notice that it tells me what the different key symbols mean. So that upward arrow that we saw on the dock, so here we go, it says upper caret, upward arrow U, that's the shortcut key corresponding to undock. Let's go ahead and try that out. I'm going to hold shift, control, U. Notice that you could see that in the bottom right-hand corner where I have my virtual keyboard. If I want to redock it, I hit the downward arrow. Notice that dock has control shift D. So now let's go ahead and try that. I go hold control, hold shift, and then I hit D, and it redocks that in the actual platform. What's nice about that is I can teach myself the keystrokes for any of these different commands by just looking. If I want to maximize, let's try Control Shift M. So I go ahead and hit Control Shift M. Notice that the command window has maximized to take up most of my MATLAB desktop. Let's pretend that I wanted to restore it to the original form. In order to do that, I see this restore here, which has the same set of keystrokes, Control Shift M, which means that I hold the control, I hold the shift, and I push M, and lo and behold, it gets back to that original form. Another really cool feature, if I wanted to maximize or minimize, I can just double click on it. So double click maximize, double click restore, double click maximize, double click restore. If I want to move this layout around, one way to do that is just to click it and drag. So I click and then drag over here. Then I have workspace and current folder. I could also do a half and half by just clicking workspace, waiting till it highlights half and half. I think in this situation, the current folder was off to the left. So I click, hold down the mouse and drag to the left. That gives me my layout. The major point of filming all this is to show you one of the ways that we're going to learn is to click buttons and break stuff. I think it's really important. One of my favorite things to do in computation and working with computers is see if I can break it. Don't be afraid to click buttons, break it, look at what the symbols mean, look online. That's how we get good at a particular software. To end this video, let's add one more feature to our MATLAB desktop that I would like to be standard on all of our computers, which is what we call the command history window. Go up to the layout button on the home tab over here, scroll down to command history, and then hit docked. The moment we do that, we should see a command history window, which actually gives us all of the commands that we've typed into MATLAB. We'll talk more about that in the next video, but for now, we should end this video, all of us, having MATLAB open, the command window activated. On the left, we'll have the current folder window. On the right, we'll have the workspace window. And on the bottom right, we'll have the command history window. In the next video, we'll talk about what each of these does. See you there.